Welcome to another video in the overhead cost management playlist. In the last video, I gave you an overview of the life cycle of internal orders. So we have seen together how to create an internal order, create the settlement rules, post expenses to the internal order, display the reports to see the balances we have of each internal order, and then how to run the settlement at the end of the period. Starting from this video, I will get into the details of each step of this overview. In the video today, I will tell you the difference between periodic and default settlement with a demo on SAP S for HANA 2023. For internal orders, the difference between periodic and default settlement is very easy to understand. Periodic settlement, as we see in the name, is only periodic, which means that when we run periodic settlement, SAP will only settle the expenses posted in the period that we are settling. While if we run full settlement, then SAP will settle all the expenses in the current period and in the previous periods. For example, if we have an internal order and we did some postings in period 1, then we didn't run any settlement in period 1, and in period 2, we posted other expenses, and at the end of period 2, we decided to settle the internal order. Here, if we do a periodic settlement, SAP will only settle the expenses posted in period 2 and will ignore completely the expenses that are posted in period 1. These will stay in the internal order. While if we run a full settlement, then SAP will settle both the expenses posted in period 2 and also the expenses posted in period 1. And all of these expenses will be settled with a posting date at the end of period 2. To settle any internal order, we must have at least the periodic settlement rule, while the full settlement rule is optional. In order to run the settlement, we have to maintain the settlement rules and then run the settlement program. I'm going to show you all of the scenario now on SAP S/4HANA. Now we are already familiar with the process of internal orders after the last video, so I'm going to go faster with the demo. Today I have an internal order that I already created, and this internal order has postings in period 1 and in period 2, and I'm going to run the settlement in period 2. So first let me show you the master data of the internal order. Here I will go to Manage Internal Orders. Again, this is SAP FIORI on SAP S/4HANA 2023. So here I will click on Manage Internal Orders. And then the order I'm using today is 400-120. So the order description is full and periodic settlement. I created it for this demo. Here I will click on Manage Internal Order. And then, as you see here, we have the order description. We have the order type is marketing and the order is released. There is nothing special about this. It's exactly the same as what we did in the overview. If we go here to settlement rules, we can see I still don't have any settlement rules. And I will keep it as this so we can see the error that we get if we try to run the settlement without having a settlement rule. Now I will switch to another application to show you the line items posted to this internal order. So I'll go back to SAP FIORI Launchpad and then go to the report. Display line item in general ledger, and here I will insert the internal order number 400-120. I have created this layout especially for this demo. If you don't find the order ID in your filter criteria, then you can click here and add the order ID if you want. So here I can see the lines posted to our internal order. So I have one line posted in 01/02/2024, so this is period 2, 14,000 AUR. And I have another line posted in 16/01/2024. So this is period 1 for 20,000 AUR. So we have 20,000 in period 1 and 10,000 in period 2. Now I'm going to run the settlement in period 2 so we can see what SAP is going to pick. So I will keep this window open and we'll switch back to, or let's open another tab. So open link a new tab. And here I'm going to open the application that we use for order settlement. So again, the application is Run Settlement for Maintenance Orders. So click here. And here I have my internal order and the settlement period. Now, if I say that I want to settle period 2, we didn't run any settlement for period 1 yet, but I'm going to run settlement for period 2 directly. So here I have period 2 and the year is 2024. And I'm going to run by period. So this is periodic settlement. Then I have the test run and check transaction data. If I try to run the settlement now, we get this error because we don't have a settlement rule yet. So let me switch to the screen where we have the internal order. So this is the Manage Internal Order application. I will go click on edit, then maintain settlement rule, and let's maintain a rule. So here I have the distribution rule. I can insert as many lines as I want. So I can decide to settle the order to multiple cost centers or to multiple WBSs or to any cost objects I want. For the demo today, I will only have one line where I will settle 100% of the cost to one cost center. So here I have this line, I clicked on insert, and here the category is cost center. And the settlement receiver is cost center 1000. And here we have the settlement type periodic settlement. So we can either have full settlement or periodic settlement. So this one is periodic. And then I will click on done, save. And let's switch back to the application for the settlement. So now again, I'm going to click on execute. So again, we have here the order number. We have the settlement period 2. We didn't settle period 1 yet, but I'm going to settle period 2 directly. And I have here the processing type by period. So I will click on execute. And we don't have any errors. If I click on details list here, we can see that SAP is going to settle only 10,000 to cost center 1,000. So this 10,000 is the value that was posted in period 2. So SAP ignored completely all the expenses posted in period 1 because this is periodic settlement, which means SAP will only settle the expenses posted in this period. Now let's go back. So this is a test run. We didn't actually settle anything. So now let's go back and try posting a full settlement and see what SAP will do. So now if I click on full settlement here and then click on execute, we get an error, debit with cost element, and we have the expense number cannot be settled. If you check the details and read here, it will tell you that we don't have any settlement rules with the type full. So SAP is trying to settle the expenses posted also in the previous periods, but it didn't find any settlement rules with the type full. So we have this error. Now let's go back. Before I maintain the full settlement rule, I also want to try here and show you the automatic settlement. So if I click on automatic and then click on execute, automatic is also working because when we run automatic, SAP picks all the settlement rules that are created in the order. And since in the order we only have the periodic settlement rule, so SAP is only going to execute the periodic settlement here. This is why the automatic also works. So if we go back, so now we have automatic, by period, and full settlement. So by period is working, automatic is working, full settlement is not working. Automatic is where SAP selects all the settlement rules created in the order. You can see the details if you click on help here, and here you'll find a very nice explanation. So when you select automatic, SAP runs all the settlement rules that are in the order, whether they are periodic or full. Now we only have the periodic rule, so if we run automatic, SAP is going to execute only periodic, and it doesn't show any errors. Now I'm going to switch back to the manage internal order application and maintain the full settlement rule. So here click on edit again, and go to maintain settlement rule, and here I'm going to insert another line, and this time the line will be for also a cost center, but I'm going to select another cost center, so we can see the difference between these two. So here the cost center will be 2000. So periodic settlement is to cost center 1000, while full settlement is to cost center 2000. And here we select in the settlement type, we select full settlement. Now save. Let's click on done and save. Now switch back to actual settlement for orders. And again, we have period 2, automatic or full will give the same result because now we have two settlement rules. SAP will pick both of them if we select automatic. But let's start with full. So here I will select full settlement and execute. So now we don't have any errors. If I go to details list, we have two lines here. The first line for 10,000 is settled to cost center 1,000, while the second line of 20,000 is posted to 2,000. So what does this mean? The 10,000 posted in period 2 will be settled using the periodic settlement rule, while any expenses posted in previous periods will be settled using the full settlement rule. This is why we have here 10,000 to the periodic rule, which is cost center 1,000, and we have 20,000, which are from previous periods, from period 1, using the full rule, which is settling to the cost center 2,000. Now let's go back and try the automatic settlement type. So let's go back and the processing type, automatic, and execute. So if we go to detail list, it gives the same result. So when we select automatic, SAP runs all the settlement rules that are available in the order. So now we understand the difference between full and periodic settlement types, and also the settlement rules. And this is a very important control point. So for example, if in your scenario, you have an internal order that must be settled every period. So we must settle it in period one, and then settle it again in period two. And you want to have a control point that if we miss the settlement in any period, or if anyone posts to an old period by mistake, then we should get an error when we run the settlement telling us that there are costs posted in the previous periods, then this is a very good control point for you. In this case, don't maintain the full settlement rule, only maintain the periodic. And if you get an error when running the settlement that there is a full settlement rule missing, it means that there is an expense posted in a previous period. So for example, let's go back here. And I will switch back to the Manage Internal Order application, click on Edit, and I will delete the full settlement rule to show you how this works. So again, go to Maintain Settlement Rule, and I'm going to delete the full settlement rule. So select the line and then click on Delete. Yes. Then click on Done, Save, and let's switch back to the settlement application. Now I'm going to settle period 2, and I will choose full settlement. So this is my control point that I will always run full settlement in any period. Now, if I execute, I'm getting this error, which tells me that we have some expenses posted in previous periods. Maybe this happened by mistake, someone posted after we did the settlement, or maybe we forgot to run the settlement. So in this case, I am aware now that we have some expenses posted in previous periods. So what I should do is I will go to the other application for display line items or any application that shows the movements posted to the order, and then I will check what are the expenses we have. Now, if I go here again to the settlement application, and I will switch back to period one. So here I'm going to run the settlement for period one. Again, full settlement, and we don't have a full settlement rule. And then click on execute. It will pass. Why? Because we don't have any expenses posted in previous periods before period one. So to run a full settlement, it is not mandatory to have a full settlement rule. This is a misunderstanding. Some people think that in order to run a full settlement, you must have a full settlement rule. This is wrong. In order to run a full settlement, you can use only the periodic settlement rule with the condition that you don't have any postings posted in previous periods, or you don't have any expenses that have not been settled from previous periods, as you see here. So here I don't have a full settlement rule. As you see, if we go here, display settlement rule, we don't have a full settlement rule. We only have the periodic, but SAP accepts to run the full settlement in period one because we don't have any expenses posted before. So here we only have periodic, we don't have full. And if I go to the settlement application, I run settlement for period one, full settlement, it doesn't give an error because there are no expenses posted in previous periods. I hope this is clear to you now. So in your business case, if you want to have this control point that you never miss any expenses from previous periods, then in this case, you should always run full settlement and you don't maintain the full settlement rule. In this case, if you run the full settlement and there are any expenses posted in previous periods, SAP will give you this error, which will tell you that there are some expenses from previous periods that have not been settled. Now you understand the difference between periodic and full settlement, and also how to use the automatic settlement. There is also one more thing that I want to clarify, that even if you run a full settlement, you can still use the order in future periods. So in period two, we run a full settlement. In period three, we can still use the order. Doing a full settlement doesn't mean that the order is closed. If you want to close the order, then you have to go to the Manage Internal Order application or to the Internal Order Master Data and change the status to either TECO, technically complete, and this will block any integrated postings to the order. So no one will be able to post from material management or from production, for example, but we can still post from finance. Or you change the status to closed, and in this case, no one can use it neither from finance nor from the other integrated modules. So we either use TECO or closed if we want to block postings to the order. But if we run a periodic or a full settlement, this doesn't change the status. The order can still be used in future periods. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel so you get notified when I publish new videos. Also leave me your comments, share the video with your connections, and check the channel membership program if you would like to support the channel and the effort that's done here. I will leave you a link here to check the channel membership. It's a program that allows you to pay a monthly contribution in return for some member exclusive videos and also configuration documents. And we also have a private Slack chat group where we can chat as members, where we can chat together, and I'm always available there. So if you want to know more details about the channel membership, you can click on the link here. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you again soon.